And how we do is, anybody else have anything?
Chairman Walder, when you were talking about the capital deficit of $9.9 billion, you outlined the two most important things, the second being to create more efficiencies to reduce that $9.9 billion number, which actually could be larger. But do you have any idea of what that projected deficit is after you do all of those things that you were talking about doing?
I don't have an exact figure now. I think there are a few moving parts. Again, I'm hopeful that we will find ways to be able to drive further efficiencies in our program as we've done with other things. We're working on that now, and I do accept that. As I said, I think the two critical components, Senator, are one, that we recognize the critical importance of the things we're doing. These are not fluff. They are the heart and soul of our critical transit system. And two, it is our responsibility to be able to demonstrate to everybody that we do that effectively and efficiently.
Can you approximate how much you plan on saving?
I do not have a figure for you.
Because
today,
if the legislature has the responsibility of helping close a $9.9 billion deficit, and you're saying it may be more, and there's all of these different ways to help save costs, but you have no idea how much that's going to save, where's our starting point?
Well, I think our starting point is last year, I went through the capital program, was able to reduce our cost by $2 billion. That's a very real saving that we put in place. We're working toward other things that we can do as well. At the same time, one of the things that we are reliant upon is what's happening in the broader construction markets, in the broader construction community, the effect that factor prices such as oil have in various things that are taking place right now, the production of steel and other things of that nature. And I can't give you an exact figure for what it is. What I'm giving you, and what I will engage in the manner that the senator has asked, what I'm giving you is the direction that I'm trying to move this company in to be able to do that. So this is a complex capital program.
So what's the number, though? The deficit right now is $9.9 billion. You're saying it may be more. So assuming that you didn't do anything, that's the number that we're working with. But you're saying that there's all these different options to work with all these people and create more efficiencies to reduce that number. So are we reducing it a few hundred million? Are we closing it? I mean, can you give us any perspective of what this deficit is after you do what's in your ability?
I would give you the perspective. There is no chance that you will find efficiencies to be able to close the size of the deficit that is there.
But I'm not looking for a facetious answer.
I'm trying to answer your question, Senator. I mean, the fact is I'm working on it. Is there no answer? We are working on it right now. I have explained to you the things that we are doing. We are trying to do this. We are trying to form and find ways working in partnership with a construction community in the metropolitan region, the contractors, the building congress, the labor trades, that has been hard hit by this economic recession, or, Chairman, as you said, depression. This is a community that's been very hard hit by that. We're working to find ways to be able to do things more efficiently. We're working to see how we're able to do that. We want to see that come back as the value for the taxpayer in what we're doing, and keep hardworking men and women at work, in jobs, and being able to do things. While I'm happy to talk about what we are trying to do, it is premature for me to give you a figure, and I'm hesitant to do so. I appreciate the frustration that seems to create for you, but I don't have an answer to that question today. Okay. I have tried to be upfront with facts and figures for everything that I have. I'm not shying away from the need for them. I recognize the importance of that, but I will not put us in a position where I am using a fact or a figure that I cannot support, and I'm not in a position to be able to do that today.
Yeah, well, you know, when talking about this $9.9 billion number, let's just use that, let's just say, you know, it was $10 billion or whatever the capital deficit is, you have a lot of ideas on how to close that deficit internally with working with partners of the MTA, internally, externally, to close that number. Yet, when we talk about getting rid of the MTA payroll tax, the first thing that pops up is fare increases and service reductions. I might be completely, maybe because I'm new to the legislature, maybe I'm completely missing something, but why is it that when we're talking about a $9.9 billion deficit, there are so many options on the table to come up with money to close that, yet when we talk about getting rid of the MTA payroll tax, the first options is to increase fares and to cut services?
I Senator, I think that is a misstatement of what I said, and frankly, let me try and restate it so that I'm being very clear. The MTA, in dealing with the deficit that we faced, I walked in the door in October 2009. Shortly thereafter, we began to see a reduction or a decrease in the subsidies coming to the MTA. In addition, in November of 2009, the state legislature, of which you are now a party, adopted a deficit reduction plan that included a $143 million reduction in resources to the MTA. We grappled with that.
I voted against it.
Whatever way, that reduction
I would
was,
have voted against it.
That reduction was real and took place, and we dealt with that. In doing that, the point that I made to you actually is that the MTA did not fall back on just cutting service or just raising fares. In fact, we did just the opposite of that. We put in place the most comprehensive program in the history of this organization to overhaul the way we do business. What we did was go in right away, cut administrative costs, find ways to make savings, and other ways to be able to do this that have totaled last year $525 million. The savings from the service cuts that were put in place were less than 20% of that. But we went through in ways that had not been done before to be able to do it. Equally, the fare increase that went into place at the end of 2010 was the agreed-upon fare increase that had been agreed in May 2009 at the time that the MTA bailout was put forth again by the legislature, predating me, I think predating you as well. We did not increase that fare increase by $1. We didn't move it up. We didn't increase it. We held to that commitment despite the fact that the tax resources were going down and despite the fact that the legislature enacted a $143 million cut to the MTA. The point I'm making here is I understand that these are difficult issues. I'm not trying to shy away from them at all. I hope Senator Marcellino heard that in the answer that I've given him and the welcoming of discussion. I'm not trying to shy away from the difficult issues. I would, however, object to the painting the MTA in the time frame that I've been here as one that has relied on the tradition on means of going and saying we're cutting service and we're raising fares. I have worked very hard. We have all worked very hard at a lot of pain in our organization to avoid doing that. And we remain committed to finding ways. We laid out a program that will in fact show $3.8 billion of savings by 2014. Nevertheless, we continue to grapple with a difficult financial situation, one that is truly not stable, one that still does have deficits that are there. And taking out the payroll mobility tax doesn't have an easy answer. Believe me, I wish it did. I can't tell you how many discussions I've had about it. But it would be wrong of me, it'd be wrong to this committee, it'd be wrong to the legislature, to lead you to a position in which I would tell you in any way that it has an easy answer.
Yeah, my only point is, I appreciate, your willingness to work with Chairman Marcellino and the committee, the Transportation Committee, members of the legislature on the MTA and financing issues. But I one thing that I'm missing in my takeaway from this hearing right now is that you are committed to working with, and maybe you could clarify, but I'm not taking away that you are committed to working with us on how to get rid of the MTA payroll tax.
I did clarify it, and I will try again. I am committed to working
briefly.
I am committed to working with the legislature to find ways to be able to meet the fiscal needs of the MTA, including the operating costs and the critically important capital program as we look out to the period from 2012 to 2014. In that context, I would be very happy to work with the legislature at the overall financial structure of the MTA, including, but not limited to, the payroll mobility tax.
Thank you, Chairman.